Okay, hello once again, and in this video it's another video about C++, and today we're going to be looking about something that is very old and very classical, which is the scissor cipher algorithm. So we're going to try to implement it in C++, and it's going to be a very short video. And basically the scissor cipher involves replacing each letter of the alphabet with the letter standing k places further down the alphabet. For k is going to be in the range of 1 through to 25. This is going to make much more sense if you have a basic understanding of the modular arithmetic, which is involving the modulus calculation and under the modulus 26. So it's not going to be a very complicated program, although it may be somehow long with very many if statements and many for loop, because I was trying to make it as simple as possible. So the first thing that we are going to look at is that we'll have to create a character array of alphabets, which are the possible alphabets in the language that we'll be using to communicate or to cipher our messages. So in this case, it's the English language, and so we're having the 26 letters and A through Z. So in this, we all know that the arrays are going to start at the position 0, have an index of 0, all the way to 26 to 25, because of the last, the 26 is going to be the size and 25 is going to be the index of the last letter, which is Z. So this is the basic implementation of the scissor cipher algorithm in C++. But to make things interesting, you can add these additional letters and numbers and whatever you want, but for the sake of simplicity, let's focus only on the first 26 letters of the English alphabet, A through Z. So the first thing is that we're going to create a function that is going to encrypt the text. So before making anything difficult or unexplainable, let's run and try to encrypt something and decrypt it. Then we'll come back and take a look at the source code. So if I compile and run my program, then let's say I write something like udom, and if I press enter, it tells me to enter the encryption key, which is going to be the kth value of which I'm going to shift the letters. So if I press the value 1, and it's going to be VEPN. We know that after U in the English alphabet comes V, and after D comes E, after O comes P, and after M comes N. So it's just going to encrypt by shifting the characters space 1. And if we decrypt, we're going to shift the characters which were encrypted or the ciphertext back with one, the same value of key, which is 1, and it's going to give us the original plain text message. So udom, the word udom was encrypted into VEPN, which actually doesn't make sense in the English, so it's somehow sufficient to encrypt our messages. But we know that the scissor cipher algorithm is very classical and it's no longer in use. It's not in any practical use, but we just wanted to grasp some concepts in the C++ language so we can try to implement something and maybe move on further to much more complex algorithms. So let's run another example and let's try the word example itself. Example, and let's use the 5 as the encryption key. Yeah, we know after the word, after the letter E in the English alphabet comes J, and etc. etc. So this is the ciphertext which you can use instead of the plain text word example, and it's going to work pretty well. Okay, now that we have seen an example of how the cipher works, let's try to understand the code a little bit. And yeah, so the first thing is the encoding function. So the encoding function returns a string as its return type, and it takes in two parameters. The first is the plain text parameter, which is of string type, and the other is the integer type called key, which has the default value of 3, which is the classic implementation of the scissor cipher. Okay, so when you have all the two parameters, you have to declare another value which is going to be returned, which is the ciphertext, is the text that is is encoded, that is not visible by somebody who has known the mechanism of knowing the method that you've been using to encrypt the text. And then another thing is called the value. This is going to be holding the, it's going to be holding, as you can see here, it's holding the arithmetic operation result, which is going to indicate the position of the ciphered text. It's in the alphabet. So the each letter in this alphabet array has got a value. A has the value of 0 and Z has the value of 25. So if we perform the transformation, or if we shift the letters by a k value, it's going to return us another value which is also a position of a letter in the alphabet, which is going to be indicating the cipher value. So we'll be using two for loops. This first for loop is going to be looping through the plain text that has been fed by the user, and then the second loop is going to be looping through the alphabet character array. And whenever it finds the any of the letter that is present in the plain text, what it's going to do is that it's going to find its position, which its position is going to be marked by the value of J, which, since this J is the index of elements in the alphabet array, and then its position is going to be added by the key, and then found the modulus, and then calculating the modulus by the size of the alphabet, which is going to be 26 in this current moment. And then the ciphertext is going to be obtained by taking the original ciphertext, which is an empty text, and then you have to concatenate it with the alphabet letter. So we are accessing this, the any of the letters or the characters that are present here, by its value. The value you've obtained is the one that is the value of the ciphered text, and then it's going to concatenate throughout all the letters that are present in the plain text, and it's going to return the cipher text, which is the value obtained here. So that is the simple explanation of the function that encrypts the text, called encode. And then let's take a look at the decode function. The decode function is also similar to the encode function, with only one major difference. So in the encode function, we saw that the value of J will be added to the key and then the modulus be calculated. But in this point, the decode function is going to take the value, the position of the letter or of the ciphertext in the alphabet, and then it's going to be minused by the value of key, which is the similar one used by the original encoding function. And then we find the modulus, then we'll have the value of the alphabet that is not encrypted, and then we have the plain text concatenated, and then we'll have the original text, plain text, obtained. So this is the main function that is going to call all the two major functions, and it's going to also to accept user input. So the first thing is that it tells the user to enter the message, and then it gets lines. So in order to accept spaces and blank spaces, we have to use the get line character. And then it also asks the user for the key, and the key, since we are working with only 26 letters or the size of the alphabet, then we'll have to calculate its modulus. So it's going to be key calculate its modulus by the size of the alphabet. So the size of the value of key will always range from 0 up to 25. That's just simple modular arithmetics. And then we'll have a new line just for making things look good, and then the encrypted message will be displayed. And after the encrypted message is displayed, also the original message will be displayed. As you can see, the return value of the function decode will return a decoded text or the plain text, and the text that is fed here is the original cipher text. So also in this encode function, it returns the encoded text, which is the cipher text, which is also going to be printed here. And that is going to be the end of this program. And for a final run, let's try running it and try anything else. Let's say a word like that, and then the encryption value is going to be 5. That's the original message, and that's the encrypted message. So for just the bonus, let's add this, the spaces and other few special characters inside this character array, so we can support multiple lines instead of just using single lines. So I've added the full stop, a colon, and a space. So if we compile and run this program, we can try words like that, and the encryption key is going to be 4. So you can see it's completely different from what was originally entered by the user, and then the original message is also going to be obtained. So that's the end of the video, and thank you for watching.